All right, for those of you who have checked your email in the last 7 days, you've probably gotten about a bajillion reminding you that everything's on sale every day of the last week, especially today, Cyber Monday. And while it's hard for a lot of people to resist a good deal, it can be downright impossible for some folks. And Sharon's here to talk about a very real issue that can come along with this intense push to get you to shop this season.
Right, and especially this time of year when these emails specifically, and some might argue, scientifically designed to make you click and spend are all over our inboxes, people struggling with shopping addiction or an internet addiction might find this time extra difficult.
The thing is, spending has been glamorized over the years.
You know that thing when you see someone cute and he smiles and your heart kind of goes like warm butter sliding down hot toast? Well, that's what it's like when I see a store.
I think in certain cultures, certainly Western culture, it's become glamorized to spend.
Dr. Brian Odlog, impulsive-compulsive disorders expert and researcher at the University of Minnesota, says a shopping addiction is not quite defined in the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, but many people struggle with it.
There's a big range of prevalence. It ranges anywhere from 2% to 16% of the population would have would meet criteria for an addictive shopping addiction.
2 to 16%. And when emails are specifically designed to make you do one thing, to click, it's hard for even those outside of the bracket.
You know, retailers are quite smart in sending these emails and kind of producing these triggers to get you to engage in the behavior. It can be extremely difficult for people to resist that urge to, you know, point and click and make those purchases.
It's also tough because the deals are sold as deals when it's not, technically.
On a regular day, you know, if something is discounted from $500 to $400, you didn't save $100, you spent $400.
Correct.
And the important framework is to understand that you're spending that money, you're not saving money.
And while there are no treatments for this kind of addiction, there are helpful therapeutic methods.
They need kind of confidants, they need people that they can rely on, that they can trust with sharing their budgets and sharing you know, how much capacity they have to spend and what they can spend that money on.
How does one approach an individual who may have, you know, told them about this struggle that they're having in a kind and empathetic way?
Yeah, first and foremost, it's to thank them for sharing that piece with them. You know, it's really, really difficult for anybody to admit, you know, that they're struggling with something. That applies to most areas of mental health. Helping them with creating a solid budget if they don't have the means to access medical care. You know, finding those means to make sure that the behavior is to help them get it under control and feel a sense of control over their life again.
Finding someone to look over a budget who is not directly affected by that budget is also key. The doctor said, again, shifting the framework to thinking that this is not a deal because something is 70% off, but as you are spending this certain amount of money you otherwise would not have spent, might be helpful. Jana.
Yeah, I mean, I want to support local businesses like nobody's business, but at some point it's just like, okay, this has to stop. I mean, you and I were talking, what, 200 emails apiece just today?
Just today. And also, this is something that you might struggle personally, but also has a greater impact on those around you, especially if you're managing a budget for a household as well.
Yeah, great point. Thanks so much, Sharon.